In the Amazon jungle, you can still find yourself within the Eurozone, NATO, and European Union territory. France, the country that can't let go of its colonial possessions, still holds on to French Guiana, situated at the northern edge of South America. What puts French Guiana on a map today is the Guiana Space Center, dubbed as Europe's spaceport. Operational in 1968, the spaceport was soon shared by the French with the European Space Agency in 1975. Today, the spaceport serves as a launch site for the European Space Agency, the French Space Agency CNES, Arianespace, and Azacosmos. France's first spaceport was the Inter-Army Special Vehicles Test Center built near Hamaguir, Algeria. After Algeria's independence, France needed to find a location for a new spaceport. 14 potential locations around the world were evaluated based off a list of criteria, which included proximity to the equator, launch safety, and political stability. On the 14th of April, 1964, Prime Minister of France, Georges Pompidou, chose French Guiana as the site for France's new spaceport. What made France ultimately select French Guiana was its favorable geography. Its proximity to the equator, being situated at 5.3 degrees north, allows for more force at launch. This is because the Earth spins faster at the equator compared to more northern or southern latitudes. Take the example of a spinning CD. Let's take two points on the CD, point A at the center and point B on the outer edge. Both point A and B arrive back at their original positions in the same time, yet point B travels further. Therefore, point B must travel faster to be able to match one rotation with point A. Now let's swap the CD for the Earth. While a location closer to the poles and French Guiana both take 24 hours to make a full rotation around Earth's axis, the point at French Guiana must travel longer in the same amount of time. This effect increases the speed of the launcher by 460 meters per second, saving money on fuel. Compared to more northern spaceports such as the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan, for the same amount of fuel, you can launch double the payload. This is a factor why the Guiana Space Center is even used for Soyuz missions. Additionally, its relative position to the Atlantic Ocean allows for all possible space launches. This is because launches towards the east for geostationary orbit and towards the north for a polar orbit would be both over the Atlantic Ocean, minimizing any risk of damage in the case of a failed launch. Having the Atlantic Ocean to the east is crucial because since the Earth spins eastwards, launches towards the east makes the most use out of Earth's rotational velocity. Furthermore, the region has no risk of cyclones and earthquakes, and its low population density of 3.6 people per square kilometer ensures minimal disruption. Finally, French Guiana is a French overseas department, which allows for the spaceport to remain within French territory. While the Guiana Space Center may be Europe's spaceport, it is definitely invaluable to the French Guianans. Today, the Space Center plays a huge role in the French Guianan economy, where 15% of the GDP is attributed to the space industry. Due to the economic boost in part from the Space Center, French Guiana has the highest nominal GDP per capita in all of Central and South America. 80% of Guianan exports are represented by the space industry, and the French Guiana encounters a spike of tourists during space launches. While French Guiana struggles with unemployment, or sits at 21.3%, 1 in 10 jobs are linked to the space industry, with more jobs to be created as the space industry becomes more and more developed. Due to French Guiana's favorable geographical location, it enjoys a higher standard of living compared to other South American countries due to the support and investment by the EU and France into the Guiana Space Center. All of this culminates into Europe's spaceport being located in an entirely different continent, where you can find rocket scientists hard at work in the Amazon rainforest.